Indie Mogul.
This episode of Indie Mogul is brought to you by Friday the 13th, now playing.
This Valentine's Day weekend, Hollywood courted moviegoers with an assorted box office of chocolate. Which confection did audiences like best? And did anyone get their heart broken? Let's find out with some movie math. Jason easily slashed his way to the number one spot with 42.2 million. And it looks like Jason doesn't kill just teenagers, but box office records as well. That is the best opening for a horror movie ever, and with tomorrow being a holiday, Friday the 13th will most likely have the best four-day holiday gross for any R-rated film. In fact, on Friday the 13th itself, the movie took in $19 million, which was how much it cost to make the movie. Guess Camp Crystal Lake will have to award Jason a merit badge for making money. As for Michael Bay, this is the second horror movie he's produced this year alone, although it's taken The Unborn 6 weeks to make as much as Friday the 13th has in one weekend. I asked you to rate the movie on a 1 to 10, and you gave it an 8, the same score audiences gave it on Friday's Beyond the Trailer. And the winner of this week's one-sentence review challenge is Ryan Hollinger. Commenting on the Beyond the Trailer website, Ryan says, "Right place at the right time, right killer killing the right teens, and unexpected thrills and kills, just like in the 80s. Runner-up is YouTube viewer Kreatlatch, who says, "Got to love when douchebags die." And coming in at number two is He's Just Not That Into You with 19.6 million. So far, the Drew Barrymore-produced film is up to 55 million and closing in fast on Bride Wars to become the most successful romantic comedy of 2009. Playing in as many theaters as Friday the 13th, He's Just Not That Into You was an excellent alternative for moviegoers who'd rather wear their heart on their sleeves than see someone else's hacked out of their chest cavity. And since the movie fell just 30% from last weekend, looks like audiences are into this movie. Third place goes to Taken, which fell just 6% from last weekend. Missing the number two spot by less than $1 million, Liam Neeson tracked down $19.2 million for a grand total of $77.9 million so far. That means Taken is the second most successful movie of 2009, right behind Paul Blart Mall Cop, which is up to $110 million. As for the weekend's other new releases, their Valentine's dates weren't quite as successful. Confessions of a Shopaholic made a respectable debut in the number four spot, and considering Isla Fisher had to carry the whole movie herself, $15.4 million is a decent box office bouquet. But The International ended up a wallflower this weekend as it debuted at number seven with just $10 million. Unfortunately, that's an above average opening for Clive Owen movies. As for other holdovers, Coraline remains strong with just a 10% dip from last weekend, pulling in $15.3 million. Henry Selick won't need to hide in an alternate reality as his future in this one looks pretty rosy. And surprisingly, Pink Panther 2, up to $22 million, outperformed Push, which has only made $19 million. Congratulations, Steve Martin, your career still has a pulse. I saw two movies this weekend. I'll tell you which ones after the break.
February 13.
You're watching Indie Mogul.
I could not resist seeing Friday the 13th on Friday the 13th, and I'm glad I did. To me, a big part of the horror movie experience is the huge crowd in the theater with you. And man, did we all have a good time. This is easily one of the scariest movies I've ever seen. I had to cover my eyes so much during this movie, I only saw about 30% of it. I'd say Friday the 13th and My Bloody Valentine 3D are not only the best slasher movies I've seen this year, but ever. Then on Valentine's Day, I saw Confessions of a Shopaholic, and I did not enjoy it. While Isla Fisher did a nice job, my problem with the movie was that it was pure fantasy. Sure, she had debt, but then her love interest turns out to be the heir to a huge fortune? That's what I call overkill. I mean, isn't the editor-in-chief of a major magazine a good enough catch? After the very honest He's Just Not That Into You, the Cinderella story just didn't ring true. As always, thanks for watching Movie Math, and I'll see you on Friday as Beyond the Trailer covers Tyler Perry's Medea Goes to Jail and Fired Up. Also on Friday, don't miss the Beyond the Trailer special, The Audience Oscar Vote. We'll announce the results of the BTT Oscar vote, as well as who won that new Blu-ray player. I'm Grace Randolph, and we just did some movie math.
Subscribe. Comment. Rate.